Hello everyone, welcome to LICD lecture 7B. Today's topic is 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier numerical and its simulation in LTSpice. So let us start. So basically this is a circuit which is given. So we have to determine the output voltage for the circuit given below. So as you can see clearly, this is my 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. We have to calculate Vout1 and Vout2 in the process. And here the inputs are given as the DC values. V2 is around 5 volts. V1 is 4.995. And all the resistors values are given to us. Okay, so let us start. So for the solution part, we have already in the last lecture derived the equation for Vout1, Vout2 and the overall output expression Vout. So let us begin from there. So V1 and V2 is given to us. Vout1 is 1 plus R3 upon RG into V1 minus R3 upon RG, and we know the value of R3 and RG, that is 10k and 100. So we can substitute it over here. We will get Vout1 as 101 V1 minus 100 V2 is equal to, we will get, if you work it out in the calculator, you will get a value after substituting the value of V1 and V2, 4.495. Similarly, Vout2 you can calculate. Here V1 and V2 are interchanged, as you can see from the earlier formula. So it is Vout2 will be 1 plus R3 upon RG into V2 minus R3 upon RG into V1. So your R3 and RG is 10k and 100. So that number will be 101 V2 minus 100 times V1. Substitute the values of V1 and V2 and you will get the result in a calculator as 5.5. And now the overall expression Vout was given by R2 upon R1 into Vout2 minus Vout1. So you can substitute the values of R2 and R1 as 20 and 10K. And finally, if you work it out in the calculator, you will get output expression as 2.01 volts. Now there is another method of doing this. So below method also can be used. We already have derived this. Vout is equal to the R2 upon R1 into 1 plus twice R3 upon RG into V2 minus V1. So it is directly evaluating the output voltage without intermediately calculating Vout and Vout1 and Vout2. So we know that this fraction is a, this much is my differential gain, where R2 upon R1 is my gain of the first stage. 1 plus twice R3 upon RG is my gain of the first stage. So R2 upon R1 is a gain of the second, and 1 plus R3 upon RG is the stage gain. So Vout can be written as AD times V2 minus V1. So let us evaluate by this technique. Gain of the first stage is given by R2 upon R1, which is 20k upon 10k, and that is 2. Gain of the first stage can be written as 1 plus twice R3 upon RG, that is 1 plus twice 10k upon 100, that comes out to be 201. Now we calculate the differential voltage gain, that comes out to be 402. Put it inside this formula, substitute the value of V2 and V1 as 5 and 5.995, you will get the result same, that is 2.01 volts. So these are the two techniques which we can evaluate the value of output voltage for an instrumentation amplifier. We can follow any of the techniques depending upon the required question asked. Now, to validate these results in LTSpice, we consider 3 sets of readings. So let us open LTSpice window. Yeah, it is already set up for you all for your reference. So this circuit we can directly make and analyze. So let me just reduce this. Okay, let me first show you the circuit which we have built up. Yeah, let me reduce its amplitude a little. Yeah, it's fine now. As you can see, the circuit to your left and the circuit to your right are one and the same. All the voltages, the resistances, the values of resistances, everything remains the same. This is 20k, 20k, 10k, 10k, and everything is same. And now we have to evaluate for a number of combinations. So we have V1 and V2 as 4.995 and 5 volts, and RG is 100. So let us simulate this. So go to simulate, click on run, and already all the values have been set. So here we have the values of Vout1 and Vout2. So you can see Vout1 is 4.49513. Basically here also we are getting the same value. So I can show it to you by expanding this. Yeah, Vout1 is coming out to be 4.4951. and here it is also coming out to be similar in the theoretical value. VO2 it's 5.5 theoretically, and simulated we are getting 5.499, quite close it is. And overall VO2 as per theory we are getting 2.01, and in simulated value we are getting 2.0094. So it's quite the same values which we are getting in theoretical and simulated. Now what we will do is, now we'll only change the value of RG. And since in theory we have said that by changing the value of RG, we can change the value of the gain tremendously. So in the first case, the differential gain was coming out to be 402. Now if I make this as RG, if I change it to 50, my gain will be doubled almost. So that is, it will be increased significantly, almost double. That is 802 it will become now. So let us cross check all these values now. So V1 and V2 remains the same, only RG is changed. So if we simulate this, we got the value of VOUT1 as 3.995. Here it is written 3.995. VOUT2 is 5.999. Here it is, close to the theoretical value. And the output which we get is 4.007. And the theoretical value is 4.01. So it's quite close. And just by changing the value of RG, you got almost very, very high gain, which is not possible in normal differential amplifier. Okay, so hence instrumentation amplifier is extremely important. Now we'll consider with RG value as 500. So we'll go over here and change the RG value to 500 and let's see what happens. So if you work it out, VOUT1 and VOUT2 everything, you can get these results. Simulated value of VOUT1 is 4.89499, and here theoretically we are getting almost same. Simulated value of VOUT2 is 5.099 and theoretically it's 5.1, and the output voltage, it's 409.9 millivolt and we are getting 410 millivolt theoretically. So that's quite good, accurate. So op-amp is giving very, very high accuracy in the results, and we have used OP07 for our analysis. So this was working with DC inputs. Now we can quickly check a circuit which also works with the AC inputs. So we'll concentrate on the first case and we'll check the values. Okay, so this is my op-amp which is working with the AC inputs. Just to show you all that the op-amp works with AC and DC both the voltages. So here we have given the peak value. Here the input is around 4.995. So here it takes the peak value. So I have divided that by 2. So here it is the AC. And down I have divided the 5 by 2 because it is giving the peak value whenever you write over here. So the gain is 100 and we are checking only the first condition. So we will check directly the output. We'll compare the output directly, not intermediate. So if we run, and I want the difference, I can plot V1 and V2 separately. But if I want to plot V1 and V2 difference, I can plot it like this directly. Like, as you can see, the difference between the two input has come. So this is my differential input. So that means difference between V1 and V2 I have plotted over here. Okay. So next is I will plot Vout. So I'll plot Vout in another plot plane. So I'll right click, add trace, and I click on Vout. So here is my Vout. So as you can see clearly, they are in phase with each other. And let's check the value of Vout. Peak value. So the peak value, it's coming out to be, I think I have to change the value of RG is fine, absolutely fine. So here let us measure the peak to peak value over here. So this is around 976 millivolt about, and let us check the other half. So in simulated, we are getting around minus 1.95 in case of AC input. And here theoretically, it's not minus. It's actually 2 volts because we are subtracting positive and a negative part. So it will become minus and minus. So here the value we are getting around 1.9544 as the output of AC in case of AC. So now let's try to give the peak value same as V1 and V2 over here. And let's check the output now. We should get output as around close to 2 volts. Yeah, as you can see, we are getting close to 2 volts, positive 2 volts, and here also negative side also we are getting close to minus 2. So it's coming all right. Let me just confirm it once. Yeah, it's not exactly close to 2. It's 1.954. So in with AC we are getting the simulated value as 1.954, and theoretically we are getting around 2.01. So that proves that you know, the instrumentation amplifier works well with AC inputs also. So that's it. We have completed our today's objective of you know, going through the numerical, solving it together, and verifying it in LTSpice. So that's it for this lecture. Next time we'll see another application using op-amp. Until then, have a good day and thank you.